Let's begin. Hello students. In this video tutorial, we will talk about int and mod function. Int will give you the whole number of the result, and mod will provide you with the remaining value after the whole number taken off of the result. In this worksheet, in the first column, we have some numbers that will be divided by the numbers in the second column, and the result is in the third column. In the next two columns, we will type the int and mod functions to find the whole number and the remainder. So, let's start typing. Equal int C2 cell and enter. It returns 2, which is the same as the result. If we replicate the formula, we will take the whole number, not rounding. To get the remainder of the number, we will type equal mod parentheses A2, which is the first argument, comma B2, which is the divisor. Close parentheses and enter. We can see that 6 goes to 15 two times and left 3, so it carries out the calculation, discards all the whole number and tells you how much is left, not as a decimal place of the original value, but as substantial numbers left over. The most common use of the int and mod formulas is to figure out if a result is even or odd. We will also use the if function to make our calculations. Click on this worksheet where you can see some numbers. Start typing. And enter. So, dividing the number by 2, if the mod equal to 0, that number must be an even number, or if it's not, we can put them a term odd. If I replicate the formula, I will take all the results. Let's take another example. Click on the timesheet. We want to calculate the net work hours of an employee. To calculate work hours, taking into account break time that needs to be subtracted, you can use a formula based on the mod function. Mod is used to handle start and end times that cross midnight. Here is the generic formula. So let's type in. Copy the formula down. This formula subtracts the start time from end time and get the duration in hours. Next, break time is subtracted from work time to get net work hours. This formula uses the mod function to handle times that cross a day boundary, midnight. By using mod with a divisor of 1, positive results are unchanged, but negative results, which occur when start time is greater than end time, are flipped to get a correct duration. I hope you understood how these two mathematical functions work. Thank you, and I will see you in the next lecture.